The State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, is concerned that despite all the laws concerning the education sector, there are still some parents failing to return children to school, reportedly due to lack of school fees and scholastic materials. Muyingo is pushing for amendments in the education sector to include penalties to parents who keep school-going children at home.
We need every child of school-going age to be in school. The law is there, but many parents don't take their children to school. Where is the gap? The gap or the solution should be in that law. That's one of the reasons why I think very soon we shall be presenting a number of amendments in the laws that are in our docket.
The minister raised the concern while officiating at the opening ceremony of the second annual Children's Rights Conference in Kampala today, which mostly highlighted education and other human rights issues. He challenged lawmakers to invest in the well-being of children.
Children who are healthy, children who are educated, well-educated, like those who go through Makerere College School, children who are well-nourished are more likely to be productive and contribute to the growth and the development of our country much faster than those who have not seen the gates of Makerere. I want to urge all of us to commit to using research evidence to improve child well-being in Uganda and to work together to ensure our children can reach their full potential.
This meeting attracted academicians, development partners, civil society, child rights bodies, legislators, among others. They all emphasized a need to develop policies based on research to advance the needs of children in the country.
We do not need to wait for outsiders to tell us about infant mortality, to tell us about the rate of violence against children, or even the prevalence of HIV/AIDS among children. Another challenge confronting us is transforming the knowledge, research, and skills within our universities and channeling these into the wider world to create long-lasting benefits. On this note, I applaud the Afri Child Center, which has positioned itself to bridge the gap between research and policy through initiatives like the PURE program.
The well-being of children is not just about their physical health, but also about their mental, social, and emotional well-being. Children who experience positive well-being are more likely to have a brighter future and are also less likely to face challenges in their adult life. I think this is something we all want for our children. We want our children to be happy in the future, but also to be people who are responsible. We don't want to have reckless kids coming up after us and cracking our country.
Enabling children to develop their full potential requires all sectors to work together to meet the needs of children at a crucial stage. Story by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.